My name is Steve Hauk. My wife Nancy and I have Hauk Fine Arts in Pacific Grove, California. We specialize in early and contemporary California artists. Early California artists runs from about the 1830s, 1820s to around the 1950s. After that period, it was forgotten for some time. And then around the 1980s, it came back. It's become very popular. It's become fairly expensive. And it is kind of a recording of our history in California. You see here a painting of Tolstoy, which of course is not early California art, but is by an early California artist, Gene Mannheim, who apparently traveled to Russia in the 1890s. It's also possible he did this painting from a photograph, but to me it feels like he actually met and saw Tolstoy. We also have a painting that could be Wing Chong, Lee Chong in Steinbeck's novel, Canary Row. It looks a little bit like the few photographs you can find of Wing Chong, and on the back somebody wrote Wing. Let's go upstairs and see how Shelley is doing with the Armin Hansen painting of fishermen walking along the beach.
Hello, my name is Shelley, and I've been asked to conserve and restore an Armin Hansen painting that was painted in approximately 1930 or so. As you can see, the painting has what looks like marine varnish on it. The varnish has yellowed and cracked with temperature changes and age. And here I tested in this small corner a little area to see how well the varnish would remove and my technique of removing only varnish and no paint. And then I put the painting back in the frame. But what we're going to do today is continue with this varnish removal and always erring on the side of conservative removal. Absolutely no paint comes off. It is only the varnish. So I very carefully use my cocktail of solvent and very carefully, bit by bit, remove the varnish.
We acquired that from a man named Carl Welchner, wonderful, wonderful man who in the military established the Dewey Decimal System at the Pentagon Library. By the way, Hansen and Steinbeck knew each other. I mean, they were two giant figures, Steinbeck in literature and Hansen in art. And literally they were kind of giants. Steinbeck was 6 foot, very big for the time. Armin Hansen was probably 3 or 4 inches taller and very powerful, powerful man. Some years ago, when there was a museum opening at the Monterey Museum of Art, Hansen's son, Ole, came down. And Ole, like his father, was this big, powerful man. And I kept saying, can you tell me a story about you and your father and John Steinbeck? And at first he resisted, and then finally about 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock, he said, okay, I'll tell you one story. He said, it's mid or late 1930s, I'm a kid of 10 or 11, and I'm sitting at home with mom and pop, and we're listening to the radio, and there's a loud knocking on the door. And my dad goes and answers the door, and it's John Steinbeck. And John is angry about something. He's been to Salinas, and it was probably the field workers' condition, something like that. But John was cursing up a storm, and Pop said to John, he said, I agree with you totally. He said, it is a bad situation, but you can't use language like that in front of my son and wife. Well, John was so angry that he continued to do it, so Pop stood up, picked John up by the shoulders, carried him outside. Well, you've got to be pretty powerful to do that. You know, even gaunt, Steinbeck was 175, set him down over the picket fence and said, now come back when you're better prepared to behave. Anyway, Ole said the next day John sent flowers.
The painting now is removed from the frame, and I'm about ready to begin the process of removing the varnish. Again, this is what looks like marine varnish because it is so heavy and very yellowed and cracked. And as you can see, I've tested one little corner here with my solvent, and I'm going to very carefully now move in an area and only remove the varnish with this Q-tip each Q-tip at a time, and no paint. So it'll be a painstaking, very slow process, and the slower the better, and we'll see a whole new painting in the end. I'm going to put on my gloves and my extra strong glasses so I can see exactly what I'm doing, and use these Q-tips. And what I found when I did remove the varnish initially is that it came off very easily, which I was grateful for, as old varnish and marine varnish especially can be very sticky. The varnish is very yellow, and you just keep repeating on a very conservative scale. And it's a feel, you see what you're removing each step of the way. So I'm going to continue with this for a while, and you'll be able to check back with us to see the progress shortly and see how this painting is emerging from its veil of varnish for many years.
Behind me you see a painting by Warren Chang. Warren's a wonderful kind of realist. He's very much into the agricultural scene as a subject and a theme. He grew up in Pacific Grove, California, and he read a lot of Steinbeck, and that influenced his work in this area. Also, he talks about his parents drove him around the countryside, Monterey County, Santa Cruz County, and looking out as a kid, he would see the farm workers. So when he later turned to this as a subject, it became almost natural for him to paint them. And in a way, it's a reflection of what Steinbeck did. And in some ways, rather sadly, it's still somewhat of a reflection in that sometimes when he drives up to the end, to the side of a field to do a drawing or a sketch or take a photograph, a Jeep or a truck might show up and the growers might tell him to move on. Behind me over my left shoulder is an artist who is no longer living, and her name is Judith Deim, and she was one of Steinbeck's portraitists. Knew Steinbeck, was part of the group in the 1930s that hung out at Ed Rickett's lab, was one of the painters and scientists and writers and poets that were there. She did a portrait of John that now hangs at the Martha Heasley Cox Center for Steinbeck Studies at San Jose State. Wonderful painting. Judith Early was what you would call kind of a modernist. She had a wonderful daughter, Juliet, who was a great flamenco dancer. And when Judith was traveling with the gypsies in Europe in the 50s and around that time, Juliet drowned, saving a little boy. It was in a Spanish river. She pushed the boy ashore, and then I guess she went under. And after that, Judith's work became darker, much darker. We've got Belle Yang. She's quite amazing. She writes about her father's, Joseph's, flight from China during the Japanese invasion of China. He made it out. He's a wonderful painter. Belle has done two or three books on that subject and a number of children's books. She loves Steinbeck, and she does a lot of reading of him.
I was just thinking you can start to see the Hansen blue come out. That,
yeah.
That nice cobalt.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And, you know, all this still has, you can see the varnish still in there, but it's really sticky. You can see all the little bits and pieces that, you know, you have to just keep working that off. It's really sticky. Yeah, it's a slow process, but then once you get the first, you know, get it down to the paint, then it has to just sit up and dry so that you don't remove anything else.
Sure.
And then you can see it.
Uh-huh.
You know, that's a little cleaner right there.
Sure.
And all that.
Yeah.
So anyway, but...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's going to be a totally different thing. Isn't that amazing? Yeah.
Isn't that going to be fun?
Mm-hmm.
But I did find something in particular. The evidence shows behind the frame is no crackle. No cracking, right?
Right.
So that was in the sun.
That was in the sun.
Mm-hmm.
And that did the crackle.
Mm-hmm.
It was still been that color though.
Same color. Yeah. It would have been the same color, but the cracking, which is what I thought initially when you first showed it to me, is sun damage.
Okay.
And so it's a temperature thing. It gets hot, expands, and contracts, and that's what causes that stuff. So, but you see underneath the frame, it didn't do that.
We have a wall of paintings in the back gallery, which is one of my favorites. I call it the human wall. It's got a lot of literary figures and artistic figures. They're paintings that are a little offbeat, but I think are very interesting. One is of the acid test, which was a famous thing that happened years ago in the Beat era. And it's by Ken Kesey and his son Zane and his grandson Caleb. Kesey to me is a lot like Steinbeck in that he was very strong. He didn't back down. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest is like The Grapes of Wrath, a book that changed the world. I mean, it made a difference in mental health. And anyway, that's very psychedelic, very important, very wonderful piece. There's a painting by Joan Savo of Bob Kaufman, who was a great Beat era poet who died in the streets of San Francisco. His mother was black, his father white, and he apparently coined the term beatnik. He and the columnist Herb Cain of the San Francisco Chronicle. He lived on the streets much of his life, and when Kennedy was assassinated, he took a vow of silence, and nobody heard him speak till the Vietnam War ended. He walked into a pub, he read a poem, When All the Ships Have Sailed. Then he did kind of open up for a year or two and then lapsed into silence again. Below this is a drawing by Belle Yang from Canary Row, where it's a scene where Andy makes fun of the old Chinese man, and the Chinese gentleman looks back at Andy with soulful eyes, and Andy suddenly feels embarrassed about what he's done. So he's really a good kid that kind of made a mistake. We have two or three pieces by William Saroyan, another great writer. Those come from his son, Aram Saroyan. By the way, Saroyan used to come into Pacific Grove, and one real quick story, if I can, is that Saroyan was driving from San Francisco to Los Angeles one day, and he decided to stop in Pacific Grove to see Steinbeck. And Steinbeck and he talked for a while, and then John said, I'm going up to see Bruce and Gene Harris, young friends of mine, artists. Do you want to come along? And Saroyan said, fine. And Saroyan at the time was the hottest short story writer in America, bar none. His stories were selling for $500-$600. He would just write it and send it off. So John and Saroyan went up into New Monterey, saw Bruce and Gene. After an hour or two, John said, I have to get home and do some writing. Saroyan said, well, I'll stop and talk to Bruce and Gene. One of the things Bruce and Gene mentioned is that they were coming out with a literary paper called The Beacon. And Saroyan said, oh, that's very interesting. And then he said, he looked at his watch and he said, well, you know, it's a little late. I don't think I'm going to make it to Los Angeles tonight. Can you recommend a motel or hotel? And they did. And they said goodbye, thinking that was the last they would ever see of Saroyan, though they enjoyed his company immensely. Around 10 o'clock in the morning, there's a knock on their door, and it's Saroyan. And he's stayed up all night writing a short story. He handed it to him, and he said, I would like a dollar, please. So they were able to publish a short story by the hottest short story writer in America, and it cost him a dollar. So they loved it, of course. And Gene Harris said, well, you know, we love John, but I don't think he would have ever done that. Of course, Steinbeck worked a long time on his short stories, and Saroyan was famous for knocking them out in a couple hours.
So I've been working on this now for a while, this Armin Hansen painting, and a couple of observations I have found, and one is that this painting, as you can see, I've got this section here beginning to look like the original palette that the artist had intended. And one of the things I've noticed while working very closely on the painting is, for some reason, he used marine varnish to varnish the painting, and all of this crazing and cracking has appeared. And where the frame was in these areas on the sides, you can see there is no cracking. So what had happened with this painting is not only had it yellowed with age, which Damar varnish will do, but also it had been in the sun. So presumably that's what has caused the cracking and the temperature change. So that is one observation. Another is that this marine varnish is so on here, so heavy, that it will take several layers of and very slow removal of the varnish. As you can see, you've still got the greenish tones showing, which is the yellow varnish and the blue paint. So there are streaks of varnish still appearing here, and I will continue with the removal of the varnish very carefully and very slowly until I finish the whole painting. Hello, so here we have the finished Armin Hansen painting completely restored. It took over 30 hours of removal of the varnish, and then the painting was neutralized so that no solvent was left on the painting, and revarnished. And here you have the final beautiful painting by Armin Hansen, a very talented artist.